friends, today I will discuss the delta to star conversion and also star to delta conversion derivations. So before I discuss this, let me consider the necessity, series connection, parallel connection, delta and star. So what is the necessity of these derivations? So normally circuits will have the series connected branches or circuits or parallel connected circuits or connection of both. Sometimes it is difficult to solve the network with just series or parallel circuits. So there may be a combination of these two. So in that case, we need to have a different approach to solve such networks. So such networks can be solved using the delta method or star method. In this chapter, in this derivation, we use for delta connection element or resistance, we use double letter suffix, whereas for star connection branch, we use single letter suffix. So if you look at this, so here our heading is delta to star. So first we write like, we draw like this. This is the equivalent to star. And if you look at the terminals, this is A, this is B, this is C in delta. And the resistance between A and B is we call as RAB. The resistance between B and C we call as RBC. The resistance between A and C we call as RAC. And coming to the equivalent star resistance, so this is the neutral point. The resistance connected to the A terminal of the star connection is called the RA, and the resistance connected between the star point and the B terminal we call as RB, and the resistance connected between the star point and the C terminal we call as RC. And if you look at this, for delta connected branches resistance we use suffix two letters here. RAB means AB is two letters. RBC means BC is two letters suffix. Similarly, RAC means here we are using A and C as suffix. So two letters are we are using for a delta as a suffix. Coming to the star connected resistance equivalent to star connected system, we use suffix only single letter R suffix A, and here RB means R suffix B. RC means here C is suffix, means single letter A, B, C. So this notation we follow throughout this derivations. So let us see here. Suppose we want to know what is the resistance between the A and B in the delta connected system. So if you look at that, this RAB is in parallel with the two resistances which are in series. RAC and RBC are in series. So we write plus, means we add these two. So that combination is in parallel with RAB, and whatever we get, that we call the equivalent resistance between A and B. Similarly, between B and C, the equivalent resistance of the delta connected system is RBC is in parallel with RAB plus RAC. Similarly, between A and C, the equivalent resistance of the delta is RAC is in parallel with RAB plus RBC. So when we draw the equivalent star connected system, we get like this. So here is A and here is B. The equivalent resistance A between A and B in star connected system, it is nothing but RA plus RB. This RC is hanging, so we do not take into account. Similarly, between B and C, the equivalent star resistance is RB plus RC. We neglect RA because it is hanging. Similarly, between A and C, in the star connected system, equivalent resistance is RA plus RC. When we say this delta is equal to this star, then we can say this RA plus RB must be equal to this. So we can write like this, RA plus RB, that is star connected equivalent resistance between A and B, is equal to RAB in parallel with RBC plus RAC. So that we can write like this, RAB into RBC plus RAC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. Similarly, between B and C terminals of star, the equivalent resistance is RB plus RC, and its equivalent delta is RBC into RAB plus RAC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. And similarly, between A and C of star, the equivalent resistance is RA plus RC. That must be equal to the RAC in parallel with RAB plus RBC. So that we can write like this, RAC into RAB plus RBC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. And now we write this as equation 1, this as equation 2, and this as equation 3. So subtract the equation 2 from equation 1, that is equation 1 minus equation 2. So if you look at this, this RB and this RB going to get cancelled, so we get with end up with RA minus RC is equal to, so after simplification we get RAB RAC minus RBC RAC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC, and we say this is equation 4. So next, add the equation 3 and equation 4. So when we add these two, this RC is going to get cancelled, and we get 2RA is equal to, and some of the terms also going to cancel in the numerator, then we get 2RAB into RAC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. So this 2 and this 2 is going to get cancelled. Then we get RA is equal to RAB into RAC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. Similarly, we can write equation 2 minus equation 3. So equation 2 minus equation 3 means this. So once we do that, equation 2 minus equation 3, so then this RC is going to get cancelled, then we get RB minus RA like this, and then numerator become like this, RAB RBC plus RBC RAC minus RAB RAC minus RAC RBC. So this RAC RBC and this RAC RBC going to get cancelled, so then we get RAB RBC minus RAB RAC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. Similarly, if we add the equation 1 and equation 5, this is the equation 5, and equation 1 is this, RA plus RB, and equation 5 is RB minus RA. When we add those two, then this RA is going to get cancelled. Then we end up with 2RB like this. 2RB is equal to 2RAB into RBC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. If you simplify that, you get RAB is equal to आर ए बी इंटू आर बी सी डिवाइडेड बाई आर ए बी प्लस आर बी सी प्लस आर ए सी. Similarly, we can get RC also like this. RAC into RBC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC. So let us write all this RA, RB, RC equations like this. So we designate this as equation 6 and this as equation 7, this as equation 8. This is the conversion from star delta to star. So here RA, RB, RC are star values and RAB, RAC, all these are belongs to the delta resistances which are known. So if you observe properly, to get this RA, so look at this, this is the A point. So what are the branches that are connected to the A? That is RAB and RAC. So multiply those and keep it in the numerator. Then sum all the three branch resistances of delta. That is RAB plus RBC plus RAC. Then that gives us RA. Similarly, RB means this is the B terminal. So we want the equivalent star, that is RB, is equal to what are the resistance connected in the delta form, RBC, RAB. So multiply both RAB, RBC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RCA, RAC. Similarly, RC also, this is the C terminal and the resistances connected are RCA and RBC. So multiply both. That is RAC into RBC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC, and we say that is equation 8. So this is how we have to remember to get the equivalent star from the given delta. Suppose we know the star but we do not know the delta. In that case, so we have to use these equations, then we get the what is the delta value, equivalent delta. So in this case, star values are known, that is star are RA, RB, RC. These are all known values and terminals are A, B, C. And equivalent delta is, this is A, B, C terminals. Between A and B, RAB, between A and C, this is RAC, between B and C, it is RBC. And the equations which we obtained while converting delta to star, those values, those equations we write like this. Then, multiply equation 6 and 7, then add to the equation 7 into equation 8, then add to equation 8 into equation 6. So then once we multiply the first two equations, that is RA, RB, and once we add the 7 and 8 product, then we get RB, RC. Similarly, this 6 and 8, that is RC and RA. Similarly, right side also we add. Multiply, then we add. So once we do that, we get the numerator like this, RAB, RAC, RAB, RBC plus RBC, RAB, RAC, RBC plus RAC, RBC, RAB, RAC divided by RAB plus RBC plus RAC whole square. So if you look at the numerator, we find RAB plus RBC plus RAC is common in all these terms. So we can take out that as common. And we say that is equation 9 like this. And we know equation 6 and equation 7 and 8. Now divide this equation 9 with equation 6 like this. Once you divide the equation 9 with equation 6, then we get like this. Ra Rb plus Rb Rc plus Rc Ra divided by Ra is equal to, as usual, we write this as it is here. Then equation 6 means this. So we have the right side like this, Rab, Rac divided by Rab plus Rbc plus Rac. If you further simplify this, we find this like this. So this goes to the numerator and this goes to the denominator. So Rab plus Rbc plus Rac like this divided by Rab, Rac comes here. And then this comes to the denominator like this. And this is as it is in the numerator. And here we take out Rab, Rbc, Rac common from these three terms. So once we take that common, then we get Rab plus Rbc plus Rac in the brackets. Then there is already one term called Rab plus Rbc plus Rac. So if you look at this, this Rab plus Rbc plus Rac, two times is there. Similarly here, Rab plus Rbc plus Rac, two times is there because it is square. So these two terms is going to cancel with this term. Similarly, this Rab and Rac, and here also Rab, Rac going to get cancelled. Then we end up with right side Rbc. So that is, we get like this, Ra Rb plus Rb Rc plus Rc Ra divided by Ra, and we call that as Rbc. That we can rewrite like this, Rbc is equal to Ra Rb plus Rb Rc plus Rc Ra divided by Ra. So means with this, we found the equivalent delta from the known star. Like this. So let us again, you know the equation 9. Now divide the equation 9 with equation 7. That will give us what is called Rac. So like in the previous case, if you write all that and simplify it, we get Rac is equal to Ra Rb plus Rb Rc plus Rc Ra divided by Rb. Similarly, if you divide the equation 9 with equation 8, this is equation 8 and this is equation 9, which is obtained already, then that gives us Rab, and after simplification we get Rab is equal to Ra Rb plus Rb Rc plus Rc Ra divided by Rc. And if you look at this, the circuits, this is the known star, this is the unknown delta. So if you want to know the unknown delta from the known star, so let us say we want to know between terminals A and B, the unknown delta resistance is Rab. So to get that, what we should do is multiply every two components product. Take the every two components product. We have the three, so we get the three possible products, Ra Rb, Rb Rc plus Rc Ra. So divide that with the resistance which is not connected to the A and B in the star, because we want to know the equivalent resistance of delta between an A and B. So the resistance which is not connected to AB terminals in the star is nothing but RC. That we have to put in the denominator. So similarly, RBC also we can get it. So for RBC, RAC, the numerator is same. Just write, copy it as it is. To get RBC, go to the star. Look at the resistance which is not connected to the B and C terminals. This is B and this is C. So the resistance which is not connected to these two means it is Ra. So we put that in the denominator Ra. Similarly, RAC, that is equivalent delta resistance. So as it is, we put the numerator as it is, like in the previous cases, like this RA RB plus RB RC plus RC RA, divide with a resistance which belongs to the star connection and which is not connected to the A and C terminals. So A and C terminals are this, other than these terminals means B. So the resistance connected to B terminal is RB. So we put here RB. So if you look at this, delta connected resistances or branch resistances, they will have the suffix two letters, whereas star connected resistances will have only one letter suffix like this. So let me summarize once the derivation for delta to star conversion and vice versa. And we have seen what is the necessity of this delta or star connection, and we have seen what is the series connection, what is parallel connection, and we have seen how to use the, when to use the delta, when to use the star, and we have seen what is the suffix letters for the delta resistance, what is the number of suffix letters for the star resistance. And we have seen first how to get the relation from delta to star, and we have seen how to get the conversion from star to delta, and we have also seen how to remember to get the equivalent star or equivalent delta from the given circuit.